Many are not aware that the pre-trib doctrine was a recent addition to the history of eschatology. Some may even think that it is a doctrine that has been taught by the Church Fathers. The truth is, the Church Fathers held to the post-trib doctrine until 1830, when John Darby introduced the pre-trib teaching. The Church Fathers, closest to the Apostles, believed that the Church would face the Antichrist and go through the tribulation. Subsequently, the later Church Fathers, including the Reformation Fathers, also held to the post-trib view. Please take a minute to browse through all the evidence that I have marshaled. We have seen the evidence of the Church Fathers saying that the Church will be persecuted by the Antichrist in the tribulation. If many of these people who very closely followed after the Apostles all believe that the Church will go through the tribulation and persecution from the Antichrist, then it must be obvious that the Apostles never taught a pre-trib rapture. It is a known fact that throughout the pages of church history and literature, one can hardly find any mention of Christ coming before the tribulation until after 1830. Not one of the brilliant theologians or Bible teachers of the pre-1830 period ever taught a pre-trib rapture and coming of the Lord. On the contrary, not only do we have the scripture backing us in the post-trib teaching, we have the support of the many years of church tradition on our side. Next, how then did the pre-trib doctrine originate? There are various views regarding the starting point of pre-trib theology. But what is clear is that it was Edward Irving who began to teach the secret pre-trib rapture theory in his prophetic meetings. It was taught in prophetic meetings at Powers Courthouse in Ireland, which was attended by the Plymouth Brethren organizer John Nelson Darby. Irving's views had an influence on John Darby and other Bible teachers such as C.H. McIntosh and C.I. Schofield. But the man most identified with pre-tribulationism and responsible for its growth was John Darby, a well-educated, eloquent, and brilliant man. It was through John Darby who was largely responsible for introducing this new teaching on a large scale. To John Darby, the pre-trib rapture theory spread from Scotland to England and then to America. The man most responsible for the spread of the pre-trib rapture doctrine in America was C.I. Schofield, to whom is ascribed the Schofield Reference Bible. Schofield included the new pre-trib theory in the footnotes of his famous reference Bible, the Schofield Bible. By adding his personal comments on the same page of the scriptures being discussed, it somehow gives the impression as having the same authority as the inspired word itself. That accounts for the spread of the doctrine. In the early part of 20th century, this teaching reached its peak in popularity through the writings of Clarence Larkin. His pre-trib charts, which were used extensively, helped popularize the pre-trib theory at the turn of the century. In the wave of a great spiritual awakening that shook Western Europe, United States, and Canada. Be that as it may, there were many outstanding men of that day who rejected the secret pre-trib rapture theory. Among them were B.W. Newton, George Muller, William Booth, and Charles Spurgeon. In summary, what I've tried to show is that while post-trib not only has scriptures on its side, but it is also upheld by the church fathers and the years of church tradition. Pre-trib came into the fore only after 1830 through John Darby. Unfortunately, the false pre-trib theology has engulfed the Christian world until today. May many more courageous people arise to expose and demolish this false doctrine that would only be detrimental to both the welfare and future of the church.